We look into the specific moment. Then there are a lot of one factor. We call it abundance. It means abundance. In this model, you can substitute between the two collections. So this is a straight line, isn't it? And it says this is the maximum amount of number that you can use for code production. Then the production of food is six because you have no labor. So it starts here. When you maximize the production of growth, then the production of food is zero. That is looks like zero. And then it starts there. Okay? Here is right the word. All what you have access to labor is used for food production, then the food production is here. So a combination of labor in these two productions gives you this function. So far, so good. And what the trade theory says, to take this function could be extended via import. Direct production or painting, and let's say the number of units in the facility, where the rate generates more access to it. With all we have done so far, I'm simply discussing this nice random function. So all of the trade is simply explained why changing increases the production flexibility. Is in an economy, and it can be explained in different ways, but what we know is simply we can extend the production. One way. So he's using all these tests just to take this nice model. And if you I want to go over the most, let's say, problematic life for these two. Why it looks like this, nothing. More or less. There are quite a lot of similarities between that one and that one. It's very similar. Here we are. There is a mix of inputs. There is one assumption. You have to remember. Why does it have this score? It's simply because the marginal product is increasing. It simply means this is one horse. This is two horses. It can move over a king, so that now it can move more than a king. The marginal product of it is less because this one is moving a foot. And his ability to win the war is quite small, a little bit smaller than the two. So this one of the units of labor will produce more, but the extra production is smaller than the two. We call it decreasing marginal cost. And gives us this step. Because as you take a good production, gradually produce less and less. If one extra unit produces more, and less, and all of it. So the combination just looks like this. So if you want to see it, get yourself a mirror, and then you see it in the picture. If this says, this is the form of the production possibility curve, because of the case of the curve. Okay, that's all good. Yeah. It's this the major assumption about the production of possibility. If you add more become happy. You can produce more. It's an extra method. It's gradually decreasing. What would happen if it was the opposite? One extra unit would produce more and more and more. This is what they call habit. Because if you get one extra unit, you can produce whatever the world demands. And do you know what really stops control? It can produce one thing that can supply anyone who demands it. If you know that country, you are lucky. And the reason why you don't know it, do you know what that is? They keep the secret. And there are the riches in the world, but no one knows them. They are somewhere out there that you cannot find. We call it a black hole. They are there, you know they are there, it must be something inside, but they never come. So therefore, increasing modern quality of being successful to give you this life hope when you have been successful. As we compare the mathematicians, this system would have been undecided. Here we go. And I'm afraid, if there is no standard, you have to blame it on these two guys here. Because they should have been tasked before the lecture. But now they will be after the lecture. But if you want to know if it's found out, the answer is, as we do it, the way they did it in the Stone Age, we use traditional methods. Invented by another brother of Pat, and I think he was going to say. Okay? So if it's not found on the first lecture, probably it will be on the second. If it's not on the second, then there is a green man in the second. It's his friend. And I'm afraid the butler was the man. So you know who's that. Okay? So this is a nice figure. He spent 4 chapters to explain. Production, culture, mix, and this food, dessert, and that's it. Then, a few words about the Norwegian economy. There might be 2 reasons why the price of fish is low. This is one. Simply because there is no fish to be fish in Canada. There is less supply of fish. What happens to the price of it? It goes. So the next relative supply is the higher the price. So far, why can this be also the explanation of the region oil prices? This is relative supply of oil with no invasion of Iraq, no war in Syria, no presidential election in Venezuela, or no corrupt Russian oligarch. Then the relative supply is decreased. This are some jokes you didn't know. Because when you invade Iraq, this idea was not to get higher than prices. Now we know it's that did the oil price go up after the invasion of Iraq? The answer is, why did it go up? Simply because if you run a war, you cannot produce oil. But if you try to produce oil, somebody will bomb you. If somebody bombs you, is it easy to produce oil? Let them know. This should have been the second lecture of this theory of political economy. And the conclusion of the lecture would be, if you want to get a president, do not invade Iraq. Whatever you do, get a friend in Venezuela, who will be the president. Don't so we get access to much more oil, to the price would not be 2, but 1. And that would be nice. But, unfortunately, he was playing golf at that mistake. So he missed the people. But if it had been really a cut, Red Star, he might have really won. The cutoff is where it is found, and then he missed. So, because of relative supply costs, prices changed. In this case, it's the labor intensive production that has paid, taking that higher rate. They got a better penetration power in the numbers, and therefore, they have been affected. Since the marginal product of labor in terms of food and growth goes up, it increases. In fact, life is easier than your spirit when you don't get it. But unfortunately, you couldn't get the media coverage to remember it. When one's rises, there are increased labor supply, and therefore production possibilities. So in this model, it would be Gallon can produce more volume of milk, but also of food, because you get more labor. And then it's a mix. So higher wages could also end up with producing more food. So this part, just to hear what you say. Or you can rerun the video. But if an income distribution effect, we have discussed it forever, but continue that like this. Trend places relative prices and domestic rates. The effect of trade is on domestic rates. When countries gain from trade, it also get more of their daily costs. Why does somebody at home could learn from it? Still, it is a goal of the country. And if you want to, you can bail it out and pay it out. Like you do, when you want to get quality size on our out of the competition, you bail them out. We might explain trade in different ways, but the goal is a general conclusion. So a trading economy generates more wealth. So if you want to go back and work, let's say, no one ever comes from Iceland. But if you go back to Iceland, you do it for life. The first thing you do is you go to the current minister's office, and that would be in the neighboring area, because there are 13 in Iceland. All groups to the Prime Minister. So everyone can knock on the door and say, hey, I am in court. And this is a game on table. We go for that. And what can you sell if you're from Iceland? You? From hot energy? A few forms in pods, and they have that. But still, the benefit of that. And it expands the consumer's possibilities. We should be there. So, consumption could be expanded. Each individual can consume more each day. It could be explained in a manufacturing model, which I have covered. It could be several factors, which we call the specific factor model. But it is because of factor substitution. So we move from one factor to more than one set tackle, then you can touch it. It's like playing football with one football pass. And you cannot touch it. Then how to do it? It's impossible. So with two touches, you can touch it. So the difference between the other and the other models is two touches, so you can choose between two different touches to produce a sound. So far, you haven't been learned too much. You could have been golfing much more than you think. But it could be nice to do that too. Do you remember what your proximity cost was? So what opportunity cost is that we reduce the production of one of the goods. This could have generated an impact. The reason why you do it is you produce more of this. So the question is, if giving up costing you less or more than increasing the production? So this is the question of what is most beneficial. What do you earn most? And one thing could be to reduce the production of this growth to increase the production of food. This less income could be compensated by the exchange of the value of the food to test this way to use food. So, opportunity is first if food beneficial to shift to this production. Okay. We show it in a few. With international trade, what it will do is expand the possibilities, and it also leads to the needs. So there will be similar in both countries. This influence income distribution, but in the sector arena, we think that this could equalize the factor cost. The big one so far is just one of the effects of the history of the moon. So, here comes consumption. Are you ready? Okay. Wake up. Now comes the most interesting part of this lecture. How many of you have made the chocolate before the lecture? You have, okay? What is an icing bunny? It's simply a cold bunny. You can also call it a butter bunny. In this case, we call it a butter. Okay? Number one. What was one? Let's return this way. What was one? In one, consumption equals production of food, consumption of growth equals consumption of production of growth, so therefore. Produce what we consume, we consume what we produce. So far, yes. Then, indifference is caused. Here comes the king, he's riding on his new horse. We are ready, aren't we? It looks like this. This is king. We are the indifference. Fourth equals the equal value of the benefit. system, and you have seen the light, and you can go. This is the long and sweet. This is the western engine. So the export or the import. Because you do one more than you produce the business. How can we pay for this? Buy us. Okay? Indifference is called up Sunday school instead of Sunday school. So therefore, we input this and place the beast. Over here, in the Francis term, you know, take this here. That's in term there. This is export. So import here is export. So they will be similar. So what is import at home is export in foreign and vice versa. So therefore, a higher indifference term will say, you can go home and paint it. Then you can put it in an email. And I'll set out if you are able to understand. So that will be the homework for next week. Trying to add consensus to the simple recovery plan and show me the effect. If you manage, I'll come to you an A for that comment, not for the assignment. But we are partly on the way to an A in the chemistry class, or a B in the chemistry class. So, that is the point of recovery. You can improve the benefit because you can choose higher in the first place. Then by export to finance income. And in that model, country foreign export what we import. Or what we export by import. So this means the word that the amount is different. And then we can go back. We call it the marginal rate of substitution, which indicates the value of shifting from one to the other system. So, it looks like this. It's a standard model. Here, there is no trade. It's decided by the quality prices of the two goods. So, question number two, since it is economics today. What happens to relative prices if you expect? So, prices. So you shift the production from here to a different place. And since relative prices are close, then you produce it. So this is without trade, with trade to trade. Which means that you can produce here, you can see. We still have a question. Not yet. Okay, come back to the question in a few seconds. So, what happens is, this is without faith. Then the relative prices changes, let's say, like this. So, then we shift this production to a different country. So, it's not coming up with the people. Okay? Yeah. This indicates the value of the production. So it's giving the same value of production. I said that. Okay? But we think that if this is the only income, it's also the basis for the consumer. So if the consumer produces two goods, and those who are living in the country are only spending anything, this is also the gap. So this is what the gap calls of the production, this is what they earn, and the reward they use takes us to the production. It's a simplification of the production. Since the value of production, you have to be included, and since this is the key income you have, that's it. So think of this as a scheme. You have two funds, ways to fund such things. Your mother's money, or the money you get from somebody else. So that is the deal. So this is two funds, clothes, and through production, it gives you an income by producing and selling it, and that is the answer. And that's the only basic value of how you use the so, income is equal to the value. One question from Philip, and one answer from this question. I'll give you a short answer to the long question. And this is the answer to your question. Can you see that? This is the time for the growth, multiplied by the quantity. This is the time for the thing, multiplied by the quantity. So that's the value. You use it to demand food and food. So that is the short answer to the question. Okay? Now it looks okay. What is the maximum demand of these things? Or the maximum demand of food? And this is a very tricky mathematical solution. And you have to ask the two French guys to come up with it. But the thing is that if I have a beef, I can use it to from food to my food. Okay? So then what do I do now? I divide it all through by. Have you seen this before? Or is this completely easy? I divide through all of the equations the price of it. What is Pf multiplied by 2 divided by 2? Yes. Yes. You see that? Because this is the most tricky mathematical equation. Equation, you will be running through in this copy. You still follow that? That must be minus, because I move this over to the other side, so I put a minus here. Let me see this here. What is it? When the price of food compared to the price of food, what is the food equals we divide it by two. What is the maximum consumption of food? If you use all your money, then you buy only food, no, only food. So then you say food. So the maximum use of food is I use all I need, then you buy food, and this is it. So, you try it again. Now we call the budget, and we have plenty of time to do it like this. And this is 2, so this is 2, but not 2, it's test. And this is the test if you tomorrow are awakened and are still able to think. What is this value here? Can you see it on the blackboard? Okay. Can you see it on the blackboard? What is the maximum of Qf if this consumption of Q is 0? The value is 0. What is left if this is 0? says, Peter, by your servant, Christ be to me. So the answer is, with very quick, extreme quick. So this is simply that is the maximum you can consume of food. What is the consumption or the production of consumption of food in this time? In this food. Yes or no? Okay? What happens if food is filled? Then you end up somewhere on food. And it looks almost like this. It must be big, but divided by size of life. Then there is no consumption of F. So therefore, this is the maximum of food when you consume in your clothes. This is the maximum of clothes then you produce or consume. And this looks like a straight line, doesn't it? So you can sit from one to the other. And it is a initial value, it is production, and the maximum. Okay? So this is the maximum of food, this is the maximum of food. So, what is this crazy? And then I would say, hallelujah, because it's not so difficult as it looks like. But these two French guys will help you if you stay in front. The people will demand a French Bordeaux wine at the end of the cook, not now, but later. So this is simply the value, initial value. If you only consume food, then you have no consumption of food. So all of your body is for food. And the number of units is the calories divided by the total. And for those of you who study the letters, let's make the unity and say the value is 1,000. It's nothing but food. Let's assume that the price is 10. What is the value here? It must be 1,000 divided by 10, which is pretty close to 100, isn't it? Okay? So this is 100. If you wanted it units, it's 100. If you wanted it in letters, it's 50. Divided by 10. Does it sound look like a straight line? So it's about minus 1. Then it can get quickly tested. What is the maximum amount of calories consumption? If it's minus 1, the value is 1,000. What is the relative price of clothes? If the price of food is 10, and the relation is minus 1. I can see the friends are coming. Right. What do you have to divide 10 by to get 10? No, it's after 4 o'clock in 3 minutes. So if this is 100, this must be 100. Okay? So what is simply what it says? You have a value, let's say 1,000. The price for each unit is 10, which means that if you use all your budget for a month of the product, it's 1,000 for the value of 10, which is very, very close to 100. If there is not too much production. Okay. And that will be similar to both if the budget line has to stay at minus 1. a nice consensus. It looks like this. If you ask me, it could have been nicer. It looks like a triumph, doesn't it? Where these two bodies. Right? We did it. If this is production possible, then we will produce this. Okay? If this is consumption, then we will not. So this is consumption, this is production, and the difference is consume more than we produce, consume more than we produce. Okay? Here is the demand for growth, this is the production for growth. I think play with on the glasses. I still have the word glasses for me, but it should be the same thing. But the point is that in this case, the demand more than we produce. But the same issue. If I had it on the glasses, it would be different. Okay? So this is input. Can I pay for it? Yes. Because this is almost the nicer brand of silver among them. So since I got the same price for both of them, this is the same. So in this case, this is what we call the production. I say value. But at the same time, this is the input I can use for demand. Yes, I can invent here. So in this case, I cannot produce all that is demand. So therefore, I need to invent. So this is the indirect production because I leave it to Brazil to produce a copy. And what do I produce? So this is top, we call it bacalao, and we pay all our profit by selling you all our bacalao. And since the price is 1 to 1, this is the amount. Good thing, that's a lot of cost, we get a lot of profit, and we extract it. So how do they still pay for their internal cost? They turn it around. So they export their coffee to pay for this import of coffee. That is just something that is a very tricky. I think I have to turn down the light so you see the very tricky operation. Thank you. So this equation you need to know. What is different in the standard model is the demand can be separated by the production. So what I demand need not be what I produce. But since I demand less than I produce, then I expect. What if I demand less than I consume? Or less than I produce. In import, more than I produce. So just like that. This is 1,000, for those who need numbers. This is 10, this is 10, this is 10, this is 10. So what we demand is that we are able to divide 3-digit numbers, thousand, by a 1-digit number, 10. Could you survive with that during the next 3 months without, let's say, going crazy? Or tear down the bar down to the center on Friday night as we go to the hospital, then we can do that. Is this a very simple has given you this night. I want to give you the numbers, you can read up. But what it says is the maximum consumption of food. Or you can find the similar maximum consumption of clothes. Maximum clothes, maximum food. This is the slope of the unsurviving map. This. In this case, we said it's minus 1. It simply indicates these two points of the same length. And comes in relative terms. And with this equation, it sounds only like you have two letters coming with a different grade. Okay. And up here and see it a little bit. That only two plus one. And it gives us a consumption and a production. If we consume more than we produce, then we import. If we consume less than we produce, then we export. And that you will have the greatest effect. You need to export to pay for it. Do you remember that? That was one of the first countries in the world. Back in January, it's a month ago. And the memory is very helpful to memorize it. So what we said a month ago is trade is beneficial. But we need to export to pay for the income. And the value in this simple model is the value of export is equal to the value of income. If the relative price is the same, 10 pounds, then the value, the norm, the constant, is the same. And then the journeys will look at it and say, do they want a car for each gallon of oil they sell? Then I think I'm going to try to save the bullshit. Because then I don't think I can keep the two gallons. So that is the problem you have to solve. As long as you buy an oil and gas, you can still buy your car. If your car is too expensive, you ask it to be cheaper. But every time, you need to pay for all my overall income. So this is just what the public told us. 200 years ago, so we've known this for a very long time, and it's still correct. Unlike, let's say, whatever you tell your neighbor, they can tell you every time, but thankfully, it's still the same. It is. And this is an export to have to pay for the money. So then you look at me and say, well, not this year. And you say, this is a way to do it for $2, $3, $4. Depending on the relative prices, you can get it cheaper or more expensive. But that depends on the relative that pay for it. Until then, what you import has to be paid back. In this traditional model, the import pays for export in that case. Only this has one case. But when it comes to French Bordeaux wine, which is very expensive, you import it in 1 year and you pay it back in the next 10 years because it's so expensive. So that has to be your back. And it's a good thing. In this static model, import is protected and protected. It's not worse than that. It could have been even worse than that. But it simply says trade is beneficial. Trade can split consumption from production. Trade is then paid for import by the export. If it's beneficial, and then you will have the rent, because it's that all of us benefit. Consumer can consume more. It is beneficial for the consumer. The producer need not produce more because the value of it is paid for by the consumer. So we say a 5 minute break. So we say 16, 17. Once we reach this job, we say 16:16. See you at 16:16 o'clock. And ask questions if you still wonder about why things are so. Still found one, according to the definition. So then why is more expensive than you expected? Especially, okay, so what we would suggest is wind mill, wind news, wind water. Okay, yeah. Okay. Okay. Yeah. You can still buy enough things to say that. Okay. So no one on your goals has done it. I'm not going to name it for a day, and I have bread for you. Okay. Okay. Thanks, it's just 6:08. We were waiting for the ice cold wind and the wind and the snowstorm and how it comes. Okay. You can ask in a region, I think it's colder than you are used. But it has been winter here last year, but it's not the norm. The norm would be that we have been going skiing. So instead of having a lecture for 3 hours, I'm going to go on Saturday and have to go skiing, so we will get on the skip. So that is the difference. Normally we love. I might have told you that we went from April to see the Marshall and not a full distance of 45. And it's up in Valdisina. It starts in Canada, I think. That starts in Vienna and ends in California. So you go up the valley in California, climb down, and then to. It's almost flat. It's steeper to ski in the valley. So it's like this. Small hill, flat, small hill, flat. And then it's down, 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 down. So we have to ski. We can downhill ski, but we call it how many kilometers. So it means that it's in Icon Street, yeah. Had to do the but front and back. Then I came really at the top. Okay? Well, when it comes to Olympics, it's all the women. So we send women swimmer. So we try to compete with you in something. Okay? So that's good. I think there are a few good things I can see in this one. Can you hear that? Okay. Well, I'm going to say, 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 a lot of people work in the Navy when we were on ship. We had a band ride. And we were kept to the right on ski. It's more or less like water ski. It's higher. So you can tell. what I must be referred to as prophet. Okay, so not very, very nonsense in Switzerland. A different word of prophet. Yeah. Okay. What part of Switzerland are you going to take? Okay. Okay. Because you have been to Lausanne, but you have this question. Okay. Okay. And then it's how many years? 10, 15. And then it's the question about speed. One hour drive in Norway is 16 kilometers. I think one hour drive in France is more than 1 hour. And 1 minute will be 1 hour and 20 kilometers. Okay.